Tentus of Love All.
So Miyu Kihata will not twiddle the racket much, if ever. The red side of the racket, her backhand, short pips for flat attacks.
One, love.
Put a nice tight serve here. Right near the back of the table for the half long, Qian Tianyi takes the first point.
Love, two.
It's a nice feeling when you're playing table tennis to feel like you're always in position. Qian Tianyi in that rally just felt like she was just magnetic to the ball.
Love, three.
Now, a big part of this is knowing what's most likely. You move to where you think the ball's going to go, but try to wait until contact. Not vertical was the call, so a warning. Please serve nearly vertically. There's the backhand.
City one.
So it is flatter coming off those short pips, but she can still generate spin here. You'll see a bit of topspin on it, but a very low trajectory. Bit of a dart.
City two.
Heavy spin comes in. So the longer limbs of Qian Tianyi, when she has time, she's going to be able to take a full stroke. It's a lot of spin there. As she's close to the table, if Miyu Kihata pops it up a little bit, Qian Tianyi will take advantage, come down on the ball hard.
Two, five.
So the biggest lead so far for Qian Tianyi, extending herself out in front by 4 points, doing well there on both of those receives. A little bit of a bottle challenge, parallel on the serve and then parallel with the forehand. Nice follow up here. So smooth and seamless, Qian Tianyi. Now these are the flatter shots that Miyu Kihata possesses. It makes her game a bit more memorable. They're low percentage shots, but she makes them a high percentage of the time. Qian Tianyi just gets a lot of balls back and keeps them well placed.
2-9.
But a runaway game number one. Not over yet, but Miyu Kihata in a tough position here.
Nine,
good deception
three.
On the shovel serve. Look to be side and top. Take another look. In the replay, you can see just coming around just under the halfway point of the ball for that light underspin. Good deception. But secure in the spin game, it's Qian Tianyi with 7 game points. Right to the baseline, the first spin shot, then a little bit more shallow on the parallel. Down the line, she does 11 it, 11 to 3, a controlling game. So players back to the table. Miyu Kihata here is going to get a bit trickier on the serves, I believe. Good start, gets herself a third ball. Long, fast kick serve. Not poorly handled on the other side, but not enough to shut down the opening attack. Beautiful wide angle here. As soon as it comes into the backhand, this is recognizing opportunity when it comes in. That's the question. When someone says, what are the tactics? What do you want to do? Well, it really depends what you have coming towards you, where your opponent is. All the circumstances need to be considered. Details matter. Ooh.
1-2.
Just chipping away. Qian Tianyi catches the edge of the table there. Good side spin there, though, from Miyu Kihata.
City one.
Well played by Quijada, but it doesn't feel like this is going to be the way she wins most of her points. Meaning in the rally, I feel like she's going to have to pin the middle, play some wide angles, punch with the backhand.
Leg, city, one.
Heavy spin from time to time to mix it up, but that's her shot, the flat shot. This is the weaponry.
One.
This is what makes her tough to rally with. When Adriana Diaz has given some good fights to the top Chinese players, the backhand punch is the one that ends the rally.
1-5.
Miyu Quijada here. Look at the scoreboard. 5 of the first 6 points at the first towel break. She only got 3 total in the first game. Someone who came to the table with a whole fresh set of skills. Or at least tactics, anyway. That's probably the most negative energy you'll see out of a Japanese women's player. Tends to be a lot of positive reinforcement and head shakes up and down as if to say, now I know what to do.
Fight three.
Chen Tianyi waits patiently for the change of pace shot there, the slow spin that comes in. How much the ball slows down compared to a topspin, a heavy topspin shot. Miyu Quijada with these punching backhands hits the table quickly, but then it just sort of slows down in the air as opposed to the heavy topspin ball that seems to be beating the wind resistance and just crawling forward faster, accelerating.
5-4.
So 4 in a row for Chen Tianyi. Right down the line, as smooth as can be. Chen Tianyi continues being her own biggest fan for a moment. And on top of every bounce, right there waiting, Miyu Quijada. Controlling the angles. Still nothing out of reach. Just running around Chen Tianyi a little bit, keeping her behind the table. Not an easy way to win the point. But nobody said it would be easy playing world number 6. What coverage of the middle. Chen Tianyi pulls the elbow into the body. Not easy to do. I think this is the right tactic. Miyu Quijada, taller than average in Japan, but Chen Tianyi even taller than her. Means she's got that bigger midsection. Ooh, deception on the fast serve. Again, it's not necessarily how much spin it is, it's how tough it is to read. Fast, top and side spin, still comes back into the net. Oh, second bounce on the table. Miyu Quijada was the one who caught her rib cage after playing one of the best shots of Xin Xiang after a net ball similar to that, except it came off the table wide. Gave her time to get it before it hit the ground. Before it would have hit the ground, but instead she hit a roller around the net. Don't have to hit it over the net in table tennis. Tennis neither for that matter, but table tennis, the rolling effect is just so cool. Tight serve inside the table. Back and forth. Miyu Quijada was leading by quite a bit, and now a timeout on Chen Tianyi's side. Defensive play to slow the ball down and reverse the spin. Oh, perfect example. Thank you, Miyu Quijada, for showing us how to use those short pips. Good long serve, and then the punch. That short backhand stroke. Her and Mima Ito have a similar setup there with the short pips on the backhand side. 9 points apiece. Very different score line than game 1. Steady spin in Xu Hui on Chen Tianyi's side with a big chole here. It is game point for Chen Tianyi. They both used their timeouts and done well after. Very tough way to win a point. Miyu Kihata. I mean, if this were like poker and you were watching the percentages in every given moment of how they were changing, it felt like it was about 98% Qian Tianyi wins this point. Miyu Kihata punches back with the short pips from behind the table. Maybe 93, either way, deuce. Closer to the table, a little bit more height on it. And it's game point once again for the world number six, Qian Tianyi. Qian Tianyi recovers the net and plays her own. Impressive performance out here. Few get this far, very few. 2-0, she leads.
Lob one.
Clever idea there as Li Sun watches on from the background. A little bit higher up in the food chain for the women's game, has been coaching the women of China for quite some time. Service warning here. Interesting. Didn't quite hear. Tried to look down at the assistant umpire to see what it was. It was about the toss. The details I couldn't tell you. It's her game. She's taking her chances. But Qian Tianyi in the controlled spin game. It's a little bit inside the table, but heavy topspin. Ooh, omiyage. Souvenir once again. Aliu in Chinese for Qian Tianyi. Oh, burned inside out forehand. What a flick here. Watch this. Goes with the spin. Doesn't show until the last moment. Completely the wrong corner. GPS fail. A bullet here. Wingspan. I can't believe Qian Tianyi can even reach that ball. To be in the right position, stretch, rip, as fast as can be. She always seems to be there, Qian Tianyi.
Two, four.
Pendulum serve, bottle challenge style, deep to the backhand. It's quite common for left-handed players, although not a high percentage of the time, so more common than we see in two righties playing. Ooh, back edge of the table here, Qian Tianyi with a bit of fortune. Let's see how the ball really changes its trajectory there. The apology or the acknowledgement because it wasn't intentional, but gave a huge advantage.
Left, two, five.
People often ask, why do table tennis players apologize? Well, oh man, three five, bullets in a row. Miyu Kihata. It reminds me of Qatar, where she played Han Ying in a seven-game thriller to take the title just last year over the summer.
Left, five, three.
Bottle challenge again, six, and right there to follow three. It up. It's very unlikely that with that fast, long bottle challenge serve, a right-handed player is going to be able to give it back to you fast, unless you create a pattern that's a bit predictable. It's been more frequent recently, but still, only a spattering, it comes up seldom.
Four, six.
Just cleaning off the racket and the face. Breathing on both sides. You'll see players do that to fog up the racket a little bit so they can remove the dust.
Four, seven.
Steady as she goes, Qian Tianyi. Edging towards that finish line here in game number three.
Eight, four.
And a long serve, but Qian Tianyi doesn't try to kill the ball, just keeps it deep.
The idea of a long serve in general is if it's fast and surprising, you can follow it up with a quick, powerful third ball attack. Starting to run away. Game number one was 11-3. Game number two, a nail-biting finish, 12-10 for Qian Tianyi. But here, looking a bit more one-sided once again. And now six match points for Qian Tianyi. From table height, this is what that topspin is all about. You can't generate that topspin without good equipment. Outstanding technique.
5-10.
Learning how to brush the ball here. Just keeping the racket clean. One match point saved. A long way to go for Miyu Kihara.
Left. 5-10.
Qian Tianyi does it. 11, the flick five, from inside 11, the table. 11-5. Qian Tianyi.